Hi everyone and welcome to Stitch Rick Creations. In this video we are creating my Astral Chimera. Kyros Workshop presented an open challenge to everyone to create a creature out of their three Zodiac symbols. So for this mess, I'll be using a very broken and greasy Twyla doll. The legs are really hard to snap. I don't understand the kids do it. How do they snap them off so easily? Anyway, eventually I remove them and I have my base ready. And now to plan. Well, as much of a plan as I do. So, I'm a March baby, so I am a Pisces. And I was born in the year 19... So I'm a rooster. And I fall on the hawk of the Mayan calendar. So I could go with a cliché and do a graceful mermaid with delicate feathers and glossy fur and all that kind of... But no, I'm really not that kind of person. So here's a reverse mermaid awkward chicken hawk. I've cleaned up the last of the gunk off her face, and I've prepped her with a layer of MSC. Her face has got a bit of discolouring from all the glue that's seeped out over the years. I've taken apart an old nail buffer to use as a base for the rooster crown and wattle, and I've got some tiny pins to stick it into the head with. Then using some silk clay, I'll make the base shapes, and as KP Creations would say, references people, use references. And go for it. Adding texture, using whatever I've got to sort of add little dips, bumps and gribbets in there so it's not entirely flat. Ridiculous. Brilliant. I want to make an armature for the chicken wings and the hawk legs. I was really limited on my time, so I gave them a simple single strand wireframe rather than do a full delightful and make them articulated and awesome. And I just, yeah, I wish I had more time for that. I used a two-part epoxy glue to hold the wires in place, and eventually it dried in place, and we'll bulk that up with glue and epoxy in a bit. Each time I come back to this project, I can't stop laughing. It's ridiculous. And now for some colour. I gave the crown and wattle a coat of burnt sienna brown to make sure it gets into the little bumps and crevices. And then after that's dried, I shall put a dark red and then do like a dry brush with a bright, vibrant red to bring out all the highlights and shapes and stuff in there. Back to those cheeky legs. I shall start building up the shape with some hot glue. I'm not sure why there's glitter in here. But there's glitter in it as well, so sparkly chicken thighs. I've got some epoxy sculpt to build up the shape and using water to smooth the transition and smooth the sculpt. I didn't really want to use as much as epoxy sculpt as I did, but actually it worked in my favour because it meant she could stand up on her own. This is the first pass, so it's just to build up the shape, and later on we're going to be adding some details. The size of these thighs is good eating on this chicken. I like working with epoxy, but it really starts off like a sloppy chewing gum, like an over-chewed chewing gum, and so it moves with gravity and it slides about. But as it starts curing, it gets easier to sculpt. I think I might prefer Millie put to epoxy. I don't know. Might have to get some more. Maybe I'm just impatient. I know I'm far too impatient. I just want stuff to be ready and done. I've tweaked her arms, wings thing, so she's got hands in what feels like a better place. It felt really weird having them at the very ends of the wings and looked a bit like Mr. Tickle. Now the legs are solid, I can add details and texture. So I'm using small snakes of clay, wrap the band around the lower part of the leg and smooth the top of the band so it looks like it's got segments and scales. It's quite fiddly, but I do like the after effect. The epoxy again, because it's super slippery and slidey, it was bagging out and I kept having to sort of mulch it in the right place and keep smushing it together. Thank you. poor thing, does not get propped up in some weird positions. Originally this was going to be one long video, but my computer hates me and decided only to export the first half of the video, so I'm going to have to redo the second half of the video. But it does mean that it gets a bit of a two-parter jobby. Now that both the legs have cured, I'm going to be using this iridescent blue from Arteza paint and give the legs a few coats. I think it was 3 coats in total to make them opaque, and then some more awkward yoga dolls shapes being pulled, and let her dry. So as a Pisces, my birthstones are aquamarine and amethyst, so I'm trying to sort of keep those colour tones in the fishy bits, at least anyway. The hawk and the chicken bits have got their brown feathers and rooster tails and the beautiful greens and blues that are in that as well. So, time for some sparkly stuff. I've got some super chunky glitter to represent the scales of the fish on the chicken legs. And at this point, my work colleague turned around and said it looked like a harpy, which I suppose still fits. So, tediously adding layers of chunky glitter, scale by scale, by scale, by scale, until I got fed up with that and I just chucked it all on, threw glitter at it until it all stuck, and then layered it up with Mod Podge. I made a plug for her lower back and layered real rooster feathers on with hot glue. But the plug thingy fell off, so I made another way to fix it into her back by hot gluing a screw in there and inserting it into her back. I've got some craft foam and I'm using it as the base of the wings. And after finding my stash of glue gun glue, I'm going to use all the glue gun glue to stick on all the feathers because, again, I was doing a bit of a rush job and really had already gone past the deadline and I wanted to get this done as soon as possible. I mean, it's only nearly a month late. Some of the arms were getting a bit loose, so I put some super glue down the gaps to make sure that they were all stuck together and they weren't going to fall off. And coming up is the bit where this video self-edited itself, so it's now a two-parter. So, give me a like, give me a subscribe, give me some comments down the bottom, anything, it'd be lovely to hear from you, and keep tuned for part two. Thank you very much, see you soon guys, bye!